Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Sir, I wish to acknowledge the Honourable Member for the question this morning. Mr. Speaker, sir, in answering the question, let me make it clear that my answer is specifically addressing the issue about the soldiers' involvement in the alleged breaching of protocol at the quarantine facility, and not the other stakeholders. Why do I say this, Mr. Speaker, sir? Because I think I've mentioned already in this August House that the Commander RFMF, after they have gone through their processes of investigating, has asked the Ministry of Health for two things. One, if the statement can be corrected about the alleged breach by the soldier, based on the evidence that they have from their investigations. Secondly, Mr. Speaker, sir, the if the for learning purposes, I would say, as we improve as we go along, and that was one of the reasons why the Commander RFMF, I was there in that meeting at the Ministry of Health headquarters, where the Commander asked if that statement can be corrected, and of course, if another investigation be carried out so that it can cover the whole quarantine facility activities and operations, and of course, involving the other stakeholders as well, because the RFMF has already done their investigations, Mr. Speaker, sir. As I've said, this is about improvement for the future. Let me also put a few background to this, Mr. Speaker, sir. When the RFMF came into the quarantine facility initially, their simple responsibility was just security, to ensure that no one in the quarantine facility enters, no one from outside enters, and no one from within leaves without proper authorization. That was their basic responsibility. But as the days progressed, additional responsibilities were given to the RFMF personnel. And that responsibility still continues today, Mr. Speaker, sir. And as I've stated, it's important that we learn from the lessons learned and continue to improve and bring efficiency into the work done. It's a serious responsibility that's being given to the RFMF for obvious reasons. And that is why the Commander has also done his investigations. Because of the seriousness of the nature of the work, Mr. Speaker, sir, the Commander RFMF has a standing directive that was issued in December from the lessons learned of 2020, the early cases. The Commander has a standing directive issued on 2 December last year, 2020, that basically says that any RFMF personnel found guilty of breaching quarantine protocols whilst on quarantine enforcement duties or whilst in quarantine will be discharged. I read it again, Mr. Speaker, sir. The RFMF has a standing directive that Commander RFMF issued on 2 December 2020 that basically says that any RFMF personnel found guilty of breaching quarantine protocols whilst on quarantine enforcement duties or whilst in quarantine will be discharged, because there are also soldiers in quarantine, and they should set the examples. Those particularly are coming from tours of duties at the end of tours, and those that are providing the enforcement of the quarantine protocols. Sadly, Mr. Speaker, sir, a total of 18 personnel, 18 have been discharged since this directive was issued. So from December last year, 2nd of December last year, to date, 18 soldiers have been discharged because of the protocols. And there is also one pending case that is yet to go through the disciplinary process, which you are well aware of, Mr. Speaker, sir. So 18 have been discharged and one outstanding case. Mr. Speaker, sir, The allegations of breaches in the quarantine facility by the RFMF personnel are investigated as per the RFMF disciplinary procedures. This process includes one, a preliminary investigation is conducted by the commanders on the ground. Two, a report is forwarded to the soldiers' unit headquarters, and this case from the company in Nandi to the 3rd Battalion in Suva, who can request the military police to conduct a further investigation based on the decision of the unit commander, Mr. Speaker. So based on the preliminary report and other investigations conducted, the operational commander makes recommendations to Commander RFMF. In this case, it's the Land Force Commander. So he makes the recommendations based on the decision, based on the recommendations or order another investigation of or a board of inquiry to for him to make a fair decision on the matter. And as I've stated, Mr. Speaker, sir, breaches in quarantine are disciplinary issues that are dealt with internally by RFMF as and when they arise. Mr. Speaker, sir, as I've stated, that process has been completed and the case has been dealt with summarily. The Honourable Tikandundu understands that term based on the findings of the investigations, Mr. Speaker, sir. But again, let me go back to the issue why I raised the concern by the commander asking the Minister of Health if another investigation can be directed by them because of the Public Health Act that we all work under as the leading document for all the stakeholders to be included in the investigation. Because, Mr. Speaker, sir, in the evidence that the RFMF had when they had their investigation, Mr. Speaker, sir, all soldiers on quarantine protocol duties, they don't leave within the total 14 days, and they even leave for another, stay for another 2 or 3 extra days until all the testing and whatever are cleared, and then they leave. But how did the case got out of the quarantine facility? That is the question that still remains unanswered today, because the soldier did not leave the quarantine facility. And all the evidences are there. I'm not saying this, Mr. Speaker, sir. I've said it already in this house. It's not about pointing at somebody. It's about the processes and the systems in place so that we can do better, because God knows when this will be. That is why the RFMF keeps insisting if health can organize this investigation so that everyone, because Mr. Speaker, sir, all health workers, they remain within the facility. All soldiers, they remain within the facility, not the hotel staff. They go home every day. So the question is, how did the case go out into the communities? That is why we need that proper investigation rather than blaming the RFMF. I hope that that can be cleared, because the evidence from the CCTV footings and everything is there. And to do justice to the soldiers, it's only fair that that process take place, Mr. Speaker, sir. Let me just add a few other remarks. As I've said, initially, just for security, but other tasks have been added on to them, and therefore, the numbers keep increasing as well. And as we speak, we have, as of last week, we have a total of 134 RFMF personnel who are doing quarantine enforcement duties, looking after over 900 personnel who are on in these quarantine facilities, Mr. Speaker. So again, when we started implementing the government decision to have quarantine facilities, RFMF was just tasked to ensure security of the facilities, where no unauthorized personnel entered or leave the facility illegally. That security task continues to date, but they have taken on other tasks to ensure that facilities function properly. And let me just add a few more of the tasks that we have been given to the soldiers. One was the checking in of people and out of the facilities, helping with their luggage, delivering food during mealtime, to individual rooms, picking up dirty laundry from rooms and returning them after they are cleaned, delivering clean linen, retrieving the dirty one from rooms, receiving and delivering items sent through by family members or those of those in quarantine, supervision of outdoor physical activities, including exercises, and even acting as runners to go and buy items requested by quarantined personnel. But this, Mr. Speaker, sir, is handed over to the team that's from outside, and then those that are outside the quarantine facility act as runners that they go outside, and then pass it back to those on sentry at the gate, and then that comes into the... So those are some of the additional responsibilities, Mr. Speaker, sir. May I also add that whilst we acknowledge that there have been breaches, and of course the RFMF and government condemns such irresponsible behaviours that result in violations of the protocol by anyone for that matter, but we must not forget the hard work and sacrifices put in by the soldiers and sailors and other health officials who look after our quarantine and our facilities. At the same time, Mr. Speaker, sir, we have, I've said about the lessons learned, we have, together with the Minister of Health, developed an SOP for our people in the quarantine facilities. And let me just say, Mr. Speaker, sir, for the case, as I've said, the process of investigation has come and, of course, has been dealt with as well. The soldier involved, Mr. Speaker, sir, is still serving. He's not included in the 18 that have been discharged. Why? Because the formal process of the investigation does not find him guilty as alleged. So he's still in the service, Mr. Speaker, sir. But unfortunately, 18 of his colleagues have left as well. Perhaps I'll leave it there for now, Mr. Speaker, sir. And happy to take any questions if there are any.
Well, thank you.